Welcome children to active and passive. I continue with the perfect tense. Okay, so see, I have written here voice, active and passive, and today we are going to do active passive, how it turns up in past perfect tense. Here I have given present perfect tense first we are taking. Okay, present perfect tense, how is the structure in active voice? Subject plus has and have. Okay, then V3 and the object, that is completion of the sentence. And here I have shown you with the help of an example. Let's see how it is. I have learned, okay, the technique. I have learned the technique. So I is subject, have learned verb, and the technique is the object. Now we have to change this sentence into passive. So see, what is the passive structure? The object that becomes the subject here, then has and have as per the subject, then been, this is to be added there, and plus v3 and the subject that becomes the object. This is the structure of passive sentence in present perfect tense. So the same sentence I have changed, that is the object, the technique becomes the subject here, and has or have, it depends on the subject what you have taken. Now technique is hit, so I have told you I, you, we, they. Okay, I showed you I, you, we and they. With this goes what? Have. Okay, and he, she and it. Along with these three goes has. Okay, so technique is what? Technique is hit. So the technique has been learned. You can write T also, that's V3, and here ED also is correct, learned by me. That is the passive sentence. Okay, I'll take some more examples. Let us see. Let us go with has the teacher. Okay, has teacher can be he or she, so has the teacher has corrected the papers. Teacher has corrected the papers. So subject has corrected verb and the papers is object. This is an active sentence. Let us change it into passive. Okay, passive becomes what? The papers. Then papers is plural. Plural goes with have. So that even though it is it, but because plural, so have. The papers have. Then been has to be there, as I showed you in the structure. So the papers have been, okay, what? Correct, corrected, corrected. V3, have been corrected. By whom? By the teacher. Because the teacher is the subject here. Clear? So this is present perfect tense, active and passive sentence. Let us take some negative. This is affirmative sentence. Let us take negative. Negative also, it will be same, only not will be added. Subject plus has or have. Okay? Plus not plus be. Verb plus the object. Okay? Be free normally. So, I'll give you an example. The my mother has not cooked the meal. My mother has, mother is she, so has. Mother has not cooked the meal. Mother is subject, okay? Has not cooked the verb, and the meal is the object. This is a negative sentence. Earlier we did affirmative. This is negative sentence in present perfect tense, active sentence. Okay, so the passive sentence structure is how? Subject, that is object. Okay, that becomes a subject and has or have same plus not plus been plus we three plus the subject, that is the object, that is the subject. Okay, here is an interchange. Object becomes the subject and here subject becomes the object. Okay, so I have written both for your easy understanding, because a sentence cannot start with an object, so we call it a subject. But when we do active passive, actually the object becomes the subject, and in passive the subject becomes the object. So I have just written both. Okay, now this same sentence, what we do? The meal is eat, so has, then not has to be there, has not been, then we three, cooked by my mother. Okay, the meal has not been cooked by my mother. This is negative sentence, present perfect tense. Okay, another write it. The clerk has not submitted the check the clerk has not submitted the check. Subject has not, verb the check is object. Okay, active voice, negative sentence. Passive, same structure, you know. So how do we do? The check has not, or hasn't also you can write, been submitted, V3, has not been submitted by the clerk. Okay, so this is negative sentence. Clear? Okay. Now let me go with interrogative sentences. Interrogative means questionnaire. So questionnaire, how it becomes? Has or have. Okay, plus the subject, plus verb, plus the object. Has the boy taken the bag? Has the boy taken the bag? This is questionnaire, active sentence. Okay, so has remains because it's a question. The boy, subject, taken, verb, and this is object. So has remains as it is. It could be have also. If it is bags, then it will be have. But here boy is also singular, it, and bag is also it singular. So we have the same question. Has the bag been, has to be there in perfect tense. Been, V3, has the bag been taken by the boy. This is what? This is interrogative sentence, active and passive construction in present perfect tense. Clear? Now let us move to past tense, past perfect. Okay, past perfect tense we are doing. Active sentence structure is how? Okay, same has and have, but has and have past tense is what? Had. Plus V3 plus the object. Okay, this is active sentence, past perfect tense. Example, I give you, the monkey had eaten. The monkey had eaten the mangoes. Okay, the monkey had eaten the mangoes. Subject, verb, and this is object. Passive sentence, what is this? The object is mangoes. The mangoes, okay, has and have past tenses had. So, had been, passive construction, V3, eaten. The mangoes had been eaten by whom? The monkey. Okay, so OBS, rest all remains same, only been is added. So this structure is how we have made. Okay, object that becomes the subject plus had plus been plus V3 plus the object that is the subject. Clear? So this is what? This is past perfect tense, active sentence change into passive. If it is not added here, then only not will be added with had or hadn't. Had, not, plus V3 plus the object. Say the example I give you. Okay, the servant had not washed the clothes. This is negative sentence, past perfect tense. Okay, and passive, how it becomes? Passive example, say the subject had not verb, clothes is object. So the clothes, okay, had or hadn't, had not been has to be there. Clothes had not been washed, V3. Okay, by whom? By the subject becomes the object, doer of the action, that is the servant. So this is negative passive construction. Okay, if it is question, are you getting me, all of you? Okay, and if it is a questionnaire, what happens? As has and had was in the initial stage, then this will also be there. So had plus subject plus subject plus verb plus object. Okay, V3. Let us see. Had example, had the books, active sentences is had he given the answer, had he given the answer, question mark, okay, had, question starts, subject, given V3, and this is the object. So passive sentence, how it becomes? This is had remains the same because this is an interrogative sentence. So had the answer been given, had the answer been given by him. Past perfect tense, interrogative sentence. Clear? Now, let us move to the future tense, future perfect. Future tense what? Future tense is we have will and shall. Okay, so subject plus will or shall, as it is, plus have, plus V3, plus the object. Okay, this is structure for active sentence, future perfect tense. You know future tense is will and shall. So let us take the officer will have, okay, signed the documents. The officer will have signed the documents. So subject will have signed, verb, and this is object in future tense active voice. Passive, how it is? Passive, same subject, that is what, the object plus will or shall, whatever is applicable. Okay, have plus been, always there in the perfect tense, and plus the verb, that is V3, plus object, that is the subject. Okay, so how it is, let us see the same sentence. Object is the documents. Okay, the documents will, because shall will not be there, will have been, V3, signed by the officer. The documents will have been signed by the officer. This is what? This is future perfect tense, active and passive construction. If it is not, then the subject will and shall will have not. The officer will, if it is negative, then the officer will have not signed. Okay? So have and then not, negative sentence. The officer will have not signed the documents. Then passive sentence will be, the documents will have not been signed. Here, not will be there. The documents will have not been signed by the officer. This is negative sentence. Only one not is added. I showed you in the other sections. Future perfect tense. Now, negative sentences. Okay? So, how is the structure? Sentence, okay, that is subject plus will or shall. Okay, subject plus will and shall plus have not. Plus verb plus the object. We have done future perfect tense, affirmative sentence. Okay. Now we will do active passive, future perfect tense, negative sentence, where everything is same, only not is added there. Okay. With the verb 3. So subject plus will plus shall plus have plus not plus V3 plus the object for a completion. Okay, let us take she will, because shall goes with ing, she will not have taken V3 medicine. She will not have taken medicine by now. This shows the duration. Okay, so this is active structure. Passive will be now for this sentence, that is, this is subject, will not have taken his work, and medicine is the object. By now is time period. Okay. So same sentence, if we change it into passive, it will be medicine. Okay. Will not have been. Been has to be there in perfect tense. Will not have been retrieved, that is taken. Okay. By her. This is the passive structure. And by now is the time duration. Okay. So how does this structure comes to? This is the object that becomes the subject, or I would take it the OBS. So object becomes the subject plus will or shall. Okay. Plus not. Okay. Then plus have plus been plus V3 plus the object. Here, so this is the structure for passive sentence negative in future perfect tense. Am I clear? See, she will not have taken medicine by now. Object, medicine will not have been taken by her by now. Okay, let us take another example. Let me keep the structure the same. Okay, so the driver will not have washed the car. The driver will not have washed the car. This is negative sentence, future perfect tense. Okay, active voice. Let me make it passive. I have to prove this. This is the structure for passive construction. Okay, so what I'll do? Subject will not have washed, verb washed, V3. The car is the object. So the passive construction, the car will not have been. Been has to be there in passive sentence. Will not have been. V3 is what? The verb washed. Okay. Will not have been washed. By has to be there in the passive construction. By whom? By the driver, that is the subject, which in passive becomes the object. So this is negative. What? Passive construction for future perfect tense. Vice versa, active into passive. And this is the structures we have put. Subject, yes. Then will or shall, we have taken will because car is the object. Not has to be there, negative. Have is there as it is. Okay. And been has to be there in passive construction of future perfect tense. And V3 is washed plus the object, that is the driver. So structure is fulfilled, right? Now let us take for interrogative sentence or questions. Okay. Will or shall plus the subject. Okay. Have. Okay. Plus V3 plus the object. So let us take an example. This is active structure. Will my mother have cooked? Will my mother have cooked the dish? Will my mother have cooked the dish? Okay. Or the same. This is to frame a question. Will and shall. My mother is subject. Have cooked. This is. Okay. So question ayer is this. It is. And the object verb B3 and the dish is the object. Okay. How is passive? Will the dish. Okay. Will the dish have been cooked by my mother? Will the dish have been cooked by my mother? Here, let me take another example. Only been is added here and the question starts with shall or will. If it is, another example I give. Will the trainer have trained the child? Will the trainer have trained the child? Okay, this is active sentence questionnaire. Passive will be will the child. Will the child have been trained? B3. Will the child have been trained by the trainer? So subject, verb, object, B3 have been. This is passive construction and passive structure for question is what? Will or shall. Okay, plus the child, that is the subject, plus have, plus been, plus B3, plus the object. Okay. So this is the structure for what? Making questions in future perfect tense if we get such a sentence. So here I complete future perfect tense, present perfect tense and past perfect tense, active passive construction. Thank you for watching the video. Next lecture, I continue with the continuous.